Hello again, Brinnington. I'm Wendy, and today Mark and I are bringing you an old favourite, corned beef hash. For this recipe, you're going to need 3 or 4 medium potatoes per person, 1 or 2 medium onions, a can of corned beef,
pepper to taste,
and a couple of stock cubes.
Welcome back to the kitchen. And for the first time, today's recipe has caused some discussion in the big local office. It turns out that what I thought was a corned beef hash was a completely different animal to what Northerners think of corned beef hash. So, following some persuasion, I'm going to try and make a Northern corned beef hash for the first time in my life. I give no promises as to whether or not this will work, but hey, what's life without a little excitement? And, if we have the time, I'll show you how I make a corned beef hash so you can see the 2 different styles. Now, let's bring the camera down and have a look at the ingredients. This week we're going super simple. You're going to need a medium-sized onion, 4 or 5 potatoes per person, a tin of corned beef, and some carrots. Now, I'm using tinned, we're going to try and put fresh in with yours, and of course, some oxygen cubes. So, that's everything ready. Our next step is to switch on the cooker and get the water boiling ready for the potatoes.
We did try to source some fresh carrots, and unfortunately by the time we'd thrashed out what actually goes into a corned beef hash, it was too late. We'll try better next time.
And now the water's starting to boil, we can add our potatoes. Make sure you don't cut them up too small. We're going to bring them back to the boil, and then we're going to simmer them for a while. While we're at it, we'll add the onions. Now, bring it all back to the boil and then simmer it. Keep checking your potatoes until they're soft, but not soft enough that they fall apart. Just keep an eye on them. Almost forgot. Add your carrots too. We'll just scoop off this foam. So, we'll take this off the boil, give it one last good stir, and see what we've got. You know what? This smells wonderful. So let's give it a try. Let's bring the camera over. Try a taste test.
Isn't it a little watery?
The purists might find it a little too runny. Hmm.
You know what? That's not half bad. And pretty successful for my first attempt. Over to you.
Good morning, Brinnington. It's a lovely, sunny summer's morning. And I just happen to have some boiled Play-Doh left over from yesterday. So, let me show you the corned beef hash I was showing you. Very different view from what we made last night.
Well, that was convenient.
So, we put a little butter in a frying pan. Melt it off. The melted butter, we add potatoes. Onions. And the remains of our corned beef. Tell you what, one little thing can go a long way. And then we just fry it off.
And it's delicious made with leftovers too.
Take an egg. And completely failed to crack it properly. Doesn't matter. It's only part of a meal. On top. And the best thing about both styles of hash is you can serve them now, and anything you don't eat, you can eat again later when you reheat it. So, a little bit of Now that's what I call breakfast. But whichever way you make it, enjoy it, Brinnington. See you next time.
And that's it for this week. If you're cooking along with this recipe, don't forget to share a pic on the Brinnington Big Local Facebook group. Happy cooking!